Hey guys, Rooted Health. Let's check out this video called Part 2, okay? This is a Part 2 of Hitler by Oversimplified, okay? I reacted to Part 1 of Hitler like a couple days ago, and man, I know that everybody's supposed to hate Hitler, but his early life is extremely depressing. Whatever I saw in that Part 1 made me feel bad for him, man. You know, he's like homeless at some point. People were kicking him through the mud and shit like that, bullying him. And before that, when his father was alive, he would like spank him and beat the shit out of him just for not listening to him and having his own ambitions and shit like that and not following in his footsteps and whatnot. And it's like, man. And later on, he loses the only person that ever loved him unconditionally, his mother. He loses her. She dies sick in the bed. And my God, man, you feel it. You feel his, like, he was so, apparently, like, the narrator of Part 1 Hitler video, they actually told us, like real life thing where when his mother died, he was like the most devastated, the most saddest human being on the planet. He was completely lost, apparently. And man, I can only imagine. No wonder he became whatever he became. Dude, I really sympathize with the, you know, whatever happened to Hitler and whatnot. Obviously, nobody likes what he did, and genociding fucking entire population is the most dumbest shit you could have done. Although he probably might be the most intelligent human being ever, but at the same time, he could be fucking, like, he did all those terrible things. If only he didn't do those, okay? He would have been like a very great fucking military general, like a great politician. But no, he instead decided to genocide, fucking tried, go take the war too extreme, and invading and shit, like, it's just so crazy, okay? He was planning on dominating the whole world or something. That's pretty much what he intended to do. So, you know, let's not waste more time. Let's get into this part two of Hitler by Oversimplified. It's only 8 minutes long. So if I talk too much, I'm sorry. It's only 8 minutes. So probably it's going to be like 15, 20 minute reaction. My intent is to entertain you guys. Okay. So yeah, let's get into it. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Part two of Hitler. And also, like, I'll check out other Oversimplified videos as well. There's a few of them left. I'll check them out. Pretty long ones. That's why I left them till the, you know, later date and whatnot. So, okay, part two. Let's go. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. What happens to Hitler now? Is he gonna turn into a fucking maniac now? Bloodthirsty, fucking cynical, like Joker. Is he gonna become like that? Oh my God. All right, let's go.
Since Germany's military had to be reduced, Hitler could no longer remain a soldier after the war.
Also, like, part one really goes deep into the how he was really angry and pissed off that his nation wasn't winning and surrendering and failing. And my God, dude, whatever he was feeling was making sense, but it could have been stopped anyway, okay? It's better to surrender at some point because of what he would have done, you know? And he did. So it's just crazy, okay?
He kept working for the army as an informant. After the war, communists in Germany had attempted a revolution, and the government was worried about communism in general. So Hitler was tasked with infiltrating and reporting on any new political parties that could pose a communist threat. A new party called the German Workers' Party threw up a whole bunch of red flags. So Hitler went along to one of their meetings, but found that they weren't communist at all. They were extreme right and shared many of his extreme beliefs. So he left the army and signed up to join the party. His fantastic speaking abilities impressed the party's leadership and supporters, and he very quickly rose to the top.
Wow!
He said the party needed a makeover, so he renamed it to the National Socialist German Workers' Party.
National Socialist German Workers' Party. This is what I spend a lot of time on Twitter, so I see a lot of politics stuff going on in there. And right-wing people seems to bring this up a lot, that Hitler is National Socialist Party, German Workers' Party, And that's what he's supposed to, you know, represent or believe in. So, you know, when the left side, the liberals keep saying, hey, the rights are Nazis and shit like that, the right people always bring up this fact. So I guess this is true. So he is a National Socialist, and he's a mixture of both, I guess? I don't know, okay?
Or Nazi, for short, and he gave it a new color scheme.
Okay, wait, what? National Social German Workers' Party, Nazi for short.
Party, or Nazi for short, and he gave it a new color scheme.
The Nazis grabbed one of my symbols from my India and put it into his flag and just... My God, ruined everything. Oh, man. Imagine if an Indian with a swastika shows up, you would start thinking like he's a Nazi. But no, it's actually one of our symbols. It's very spiritual, okay?
These weren't very specific on policy, but Hitler made extravagant promises to return Germany to its former glory by undoing the Treaty of Versailles and reuniting all ethnic Germans into one nation. He also said that only pure Aryan people should be allowed to be citizens and that all Jews would lose their citizenship.
Whoa.
These ideas were already common in extreme right politics, but what set the Nazis apart was Hitler himself.
This perfection shit needs to stop! How can you, like, give some group of people access to something and not give the other group of people the access? Like, how can you, like, dude, you could have, like, thought deeply about it and, like, man, this is not right. You know, it's not going to help. I don't know, man. It's just ridiculous. It's not good.
And they quickly became the leading party on the extreme right. Many of the political parties in Germany at the time had paramilitary wings, and the Nazis were no different. Hitler set up the very descriptive Whole Protection Detachment, later changed to the very delightful Gymnastic and Sports Division, and finally settling on the ominous Storm Detachment, or SA for short. Their job was to defend Nazi party meetings and intimidate political opponents. And they would frequently engage in battles with communists on the streets. Since the Allies or SA for short. Their job was to defend Nazi party meetings, ominous attachment, later changed to the very delightful Gymnastic and Sports Division, and finally settling on the ominous Storm Detachment, or SA for short.
Okay.
Their job was to defend Nazi party meetings and intimidate political opponents.
And
they would frequently engage in battles with communists on the streets. Since the Allies had demanded a reduction in Germany's military size, many trained soldiers were left unemployed. They liked the Nazi ideology, and it was only natural for them to join the SA, which grew larger and larger over time.
Oh my God!
The new Democrats.
Hey, you know what? If you're like from the right-wing side, you know, please don't take this, you know... Like, hey, man, I'm a right-wing guy, and looking at all this, I'm probably wrong at being a right-wing guy. I should not be a right-wing guy. Maybe I should shift to the liberal side, and should, like, don't think like that, okay? This is a certain incident, like a certain moment in history, okay? You being right-wing is not a danger, okay? It's not a problem, okay? You just believe, people believe in several different things. Most people, you know, become part of two groups, okay? The left and the right, okay? None of it is fascist, okay? None of it is communist, okay? All you have to do is get together and do everything for yourself, for everybody in a balanced state. Okay, that's all I could say, okay? Don't feel like you're extreme by, you know, watching this and feeling like, oh, shit, I'm right-wing, oh, fuck, I might have made a mistake. Don't do that, okay? You are what you are. Believe in yourself, okay? Just don't go extreme, that's it.
The Democratic government that formed after World War I was pretty weak and ineffective. In order to pay reparations to the Allies, it started printing more money. The problem is that printing money doesn't actually give a country more money, it just makes money less valuable. So
yeah.
As the country printed more and more money, it became worth less and less. Currency crashed. In
1919,
one US dollar was worth about 4 German marks. By December 1923, one US dollar was equal to 4.2 trillion marks.
Jeez.
The price of bread rose to 200 billion marks.
Wow.
Banknotes became worthless. Unsurprisingly, such an economic...
Might as well grab all that money and shove it somewhere in the back somewhere. Like, put it somewhere in a suitcase and hide it. because when the currency value rises, you are the king, okay?
Crisis. Germany struggled to pay the Allies. Hmm. The French were pissed about this, so they occupied the Ruhr, an area full of factories, and took the economic output from the area as payment. Oh. They treated the German civilians badly, and in total, approximately 130 Germans were killed during the occupation. Hmm. Germans were furious, and Hitler and the Nazis thought that now would be a great time to lead a revolution. Oh. In November 1923, inspired by something a certain bold Italian
Mussolini.
Did a year earlier, Hitler stormed a meeting at a beer hall and called for an uprising against the government. With his supporters, he marched on the streets of Munich, hoping the police would join his side. They did not.
Oh, fuck, no! What?
Hitler was put on trial for treason. He could have been sentenced to life, but the right-wing judges thought he was a...
Hey, you know what? It could have ended right there if he shot properly. This is ridiculous.
Pretty cool guy. Hitler knew the judges and knew that they would be lenient, so he took the opportunity to make impassioned speeches during the trial. And in the end, he was sentenced to just 5 years in prison, of which he only served 9 months. And when I say prison, it was more like a pleasant hotel stay where he had plenty of time to write a book.
That's where he wrote the book. The infamous book, Mein Kampf, or something like all his rage put into it. Everything that he didn't like or something like that. Oh, my God. Crazy. Crazy shit, okay? So that's where he was completely... Apparently, I've seen some videos, like historical videos. They show, like, Hitler as, you know, in the cell, in the jail cell. He was, like, completely... Really defeated. Felt like he was lost. Like, he was completely, like... Man, I'm such a fucking loser. That's what he was thinking. And in his misery, he wrote this book. Okay? And then he, you know, finally somebody gave him like, hey, you still are very important personality. So come out, join us and shit like that. That gave him encouragement. And that's where everything went to shit. Okay? They should have never done that. Fuck!
The whole affair was covered by the media nationwide, and it made Hitler famous. Hitler and his extreme message were now known throughout Germany, but the everyday German still didn't care much for him. In the 1928 election, the Nazis only won about 2% of the vote. Many were still intimidated by all the violence and the shouting and how unpolitician-like he was, but a new economic crisis would change all of that. To help Germany pay its reparations, America agreed to give it loans. In October 1929, the Wall Street crash happened, and America wanted its money back. The economic strain this put on an already struggling Germany was severe. Unemployment skyrocketed, poverty was widespread, and Germans were sick of it. It was clear that the newly formed democracy wasn't working. In the face of crisis, Germans began moving to the political extremes. If you were German and wanted to change, your choices now...
When the society is degrading... people take to the extremes, and that's why what's happening in the Western society right now. It's like women are all fucked up, dirty motherfuckers now. Women are all terrible humans now. Like they just sleep with anybody in the Western society. It's just crazy. That's ridiculous. Okay, that's women, and men are like they don't give a fuck about each other. That's how bad it is. And like also like there's so many demographics in there. It you can only imagine. Like anything can happen anytime, and you can make a big ass civil war out of nowhere. Okay, that's how I feel like when I see the Western society and how people are like so political about everything. It's crazy, man. It's crazy, okay? Especially the women, they're like complete fucking degenerates. They're like whores, man. Holy shit. Like OnlyFans and all this Instagram shit. It's like I see nudity everywhere on Twitter. Everywhere. It's like some random dude just posts something and everybody's like drooling over it. It's like, what the fuck? It's crazy, okay?
Either the communists or the Nazis. Hitler claimed that he was the only one who could return Germany to its former glory. Yeah. The Nazi party used propaganda to make Hitler seem like a great and powerful man, and they gave the German people a scapegoat to blame for all their suffering. Huh. The promise of a single strong dictator was a breath of fresh air for Germans after years of failing democracy.
Wow.
Some bought into his extreme ideology. Some didn't agree with the racism, but were willing to vote for him anyway. Many didn't know much about politics at all, but just got caught up in the hype.
Election Why are we yelling?
After election, the Nazis became more and more popular, until in 1932, they became the biggest party in the German parliament. Hitler came to truly believe that he was some sort of great, destined savior of Germany.
Wow.
He turned megalomaniac. He decided to run for president, and did surprisingly well, but still lost to the extremely popular World War I general, Paul von Hindenburg.
Oh, Hindenburg!
Since he was now the leader of the biggest party, though, he demanded President Hindenburg make him chancellor. But Hindenburg was reluctant, seeing that Hitler was clearly such a big racist. Industry leaders urged Hindenburg to give Hitler the chancellorship, fearing the rising...
Yeah, at least he noticed something wrong about Hitler and, you know, tried to stop, which is awesome, okay?
...port for communism. And leader of the Center Party, von Papen, who had been secretly negotiating with Hitler, said to Hindenburg, how about we make Hitler chancellor on the condition that I get to be vice chancellor and most government jobs go to us moderate conservatives? That way, I'll get to keep my power. I mean, we'll get to keep our power and we'll control Hitler like he's our angry little...
No! That's so stupid! You're gonna control him. What is this, a fucking movie? You're gonna control him. That's just stupid. You just gave him what he wanted. And you don't even know what the fuck to do after that. You're gonna control him? Why are you gonna control him with? Like, what are you gonna control him with? Like, really?
What could possibly go wrong? As it turned out...
Everything! That right there is wrong! Come on, just because you're greedy and you've been talking to Hitler, you bitch? What the fuck?
Everything. Hitler became Chancellor of Germany in January 1933, but he was not yet a dictator. In February, the German parliament building was set on fire. Historians still aren't sure who did it, and many suspect the Nazis did it themselves, but Hitler blamed the communists, and he convinced President Hindenburg to sign an emergency decree allowing him to imprison all communists and other political opponents. Communists and others were sent off to the first concentration camp in Dachau. At this time, the elderly President Hindenburg passed away, giving Hitler the perfect opportunity. He introduced a law to Parliament that would allow him to make all future laws and decisions entirely on his own. With his political opponents imprisoned and the SA intimidating others, Hitler's law passed. Just 2 months after becoming...
Political opponents in prison. That right there should send you all the fucking message in the world. This dude will fuck you up. This dude will do anything he wants. Anything that is against him, he's gonna imprison them. And she'll like, come on, dude. People should have noticed that shit as a big red flag. Come on.
Being chancellor, Hitler was now a dictator. He still had one problem. The leader of the SA wanted the SA to take over the job of the regular German army. And the German army didn't like that idea. Hitler needed to maintain the support of his professionally trained German army, more so than his rough and rowdy SA. So one night in June 1934, he had Rom and many other of his own SA officers rounded up and murdered. While he was at it, he took the opportunity to brutally settle some personal scores as well.
What is it with these people that group up people and kill them, murder them? What's with these murderers? Do they not feel any terribleness in them? Like, oh shit, I just killed a bunch of people. I might have not shot the bullet, but I did it with my people. With my army. Like, do they not feel guilty? And yet they have these strong-ass beliefs like, hey, this is what's right, and this is why I'm the savior, and God has appointed me. And also, like, ridiculously, they believe in God when they're, like, murdering people and shit. It's crazy. Some of the people are so... Some of the crazy politicians from the history are insane. Okay, they don't even understand what the fuck they believe in. That's how crazy they are. And also, like, massive hypocrites. Ridiculous.
Well,
okay?
Politicians who had disagreed with him in the past, reporters who had printed negative articles about him, one guy who did absolutely nothing, but they thought he was someone else. In some cases, even their families were murdered. In total, up to 200 people were killed in what became known as the Night of the Long Knives. The army, now satisfied that they wouldn't be replaced, pledged total allegiance to their new Führer. And Hitler's control.
So this motherfucker was so controlling that he was like anybody that is even suspicious, even if that person might not be the one that is actually the person that he's after, he killed them. Like 200 people, anybody that could be suspicious or against him, that could you know, take him down or something like that, he had them killed. And now he's like controlling, like. Like, completely owning the house here. That's fucked up. Like, imagine, like, you're a big family, right? Some random-ass, dumb-ass stranger from the street came into your house, and now he's fucking, you know, I don't know, dominating your fucking family and, you know, fucking controlling you and shit. That's how it is. Holy fuck.
Was now absolute. Life in Germany changed violently. Freedom of the press, expression, and public assembly were suspended. Jews were initially branded and their businesses boycotted. And eventually, Hitler would go...
Hey, apparently, I seen some videos where apparently Jews were causing some problems for the Germans and stuff. If you want like protest, why you gotta fucking genocide them? What the fuck? Like, holy shit, that is so fucking crazy. Like, you wanted to fucking, wow, man, that is so inhumane. Where did your humanity go, Hitler? Where is your humanity? Did you not have a loving mother? You loved your mother so much, but then you're here killing people. Bro, at some point you gotta be like, hey, my mother loves you so much. She knows what a nice person I am. Then why am I acting all evil? You should think about yourself first before you do all this. Like, how can you even do this? I don't think even animals do this to each other. Like, what the fuck, dude? What a fucking tragic, tragic,
6 million
tragedy.
Men, women, and children killed in concentration camps.
Hundreds of people were. So your control is so fucking hardcore that you had to kill 6 million to get your way. This is the most fucked up shit I've ever seen. Holy fuck. Oh man.
Were forced into sterilization for physical and mental imperfections. The Hitler Youth became a way to brainwash the young. Boys were trained to fight and returned home from camp violent. Girls were told their purpose was to have many pure Aryan children, and they would sometimes return from camp pregnant. When their parents were understandably horrified, their children would threaten to turn them over to the Gestapo for standing in the way of Germany's greatness. The standard greeting changed.
So much brainwashing that imagine your own daughter, dude, going out there getting pregnant and coming back and then like, hey, you say anything, I'm going to be fucking arresting you, telling you the fucking Gestapo and everything. I'm going to be speak on you and shit like that. Oh my God, that's terrifying. The amount of brainwashing is terrifying, man. Holy shit, like you can't even talk to these. These are girls. These are women. These are young, impressionable women. And they're like getting fucked because brainwashing. My God. How stupid can you be?
And you could be sent to a concentration camp for not using it. This way, it seemed like everyone
Hail
was
Hitler.
A Nazi supporter. If you dare to oppose Hitler or speak
you
out...
You gotta say Hail Hitler or else you will not be. Oh my God, you're gonna be sent to concentration camp where like bodies and bodies and bodies. Fuck this. Holy shit. What happened to Hitler? What happened? How can he become so evil all of a sudden like this? Like, did he not think that this was fucking stupid? Holy shit, bro. Whatever you were doing was fucking inhumane to level 9000. I can't believe this.
You also would be sent to a concentration camp.
Oh my God.
German nationalism captivated the young Adolf. Extreme ideology and anti-Semitism festered in him as a young man living a hard life on the streets.
Yeah, I mean, as a young man with all that depression, all those bullying, getting bullied and all that homelessness and all of that, your mother dying, your father beating when he was alive, all that can contribute to some evil behavior. But at some point, you gotta think, like, you're evil, okay? You're evil, you fucking rob some stores, you're a fucking criminal, or I guess, but... genociding people, bro. What the fuck is this? Like, what? Dude, you have to be a mentally ill moron from a mental asylum to act like this. Is he lost or something? Is he psychologically fucked or something?
Germany's defeat in the First World War filled him with hatred and a thirst for vengeance.
Okay, so Germany's defeat in the World War angered him even more.
A political movement that treated him like a god. And hundreds of thousands looking up to him as their savior made him a megalomaniac.
Wow.
And soon, his aggressive foreign policies...
Hey, at some point you gotta think like, dude, I'm acting kinda extreme. Is this really the answer to my nation? Is this how I'm gonna, push the future of our nation like this? You know, you should think. You should think about yourself whatever you're doing. But no. This dude is like happily going through whatever that's happening. Fuck.
Would drag the world into a
whatever makes him feel good. He's like, let's feel it. Let's just do it. Okay, let's kill 6 million Jews. Like, holy shit.
Global conflict.
Okay, wait, what?
Foreign policies would drag the world into a second.
He's aggressive.
And soon, his aggressive foreign policies would drag the world into a second tragic global conflict.
Wow.
Otherwise known as
World War II. I seen World War II, by the way. I did the reaction. I'll put that reaction at the end of this video, okay? My God. Oh, God. Man. Okay, this... Bruh. This dude is insane, okay? My God, this is the most craziest video I think I've ever seen. Even the narrator of this video was like, very calm with whatever Hitler did. He was not... speaking it wildly or saying things in a comedic fashion. No, he was like calm and serious. Whatever Hitler did, bro, like, I don't think even crazy people out there in the homeless people that are crazy, you know, even I don't think they would do that. Like, what? Bro, what were you thinking? You think you're gonna be alive? You're gonna be fucking ruling this world with the fucking bullshit that you did? You think goodness, kindness, and morality is not gonna win over in the end? You thought your bullshit is gonna be the ruling thing forever? You're gonna rule the world forever? Is that what you thought? Like, bro. This is fucking insane. This is insane, man. This makes me shocked. And, one thing I gotta say about the Western society, bro, you people need to calm down. Don't take this too into your heart and shit. Don't take this extremely serious and stuff. I mean, just remember, okay? Teach it to your younger generations. Show them what happened. Make them cautious. But don't take it so seriously to the point where you're constantly paranoid. Like, I see the left and right going constantly paranoid mode. Like, hey, you are the fascist. Hey, you are the commie bastard and shit like that. You are the fascist. You are the fact. Like, so many antifa and shit like that. Oh my God, there's so much paranoia of fear. Okay? This is one dude's doing. Hitler's doing. We are intelligent now. We are not this fucking stupid, okay? Nobody's gonna ever do... This is a history. One of the most important fucking incidents. One of the most tragedy incidents of our history, man. As the entire mankind's history, okay? Everybody's gonna fucking remember it till the day this fucking ends. This world ends, okay? You know, don't be paranoid. Be friends. Be brothers to each other. We gotta make good overcome bad. So in order to do that, we gotta, regardless of our differences, we gotta get together. Okay. I see a lot of that paranoia going on, but yeah. Hitler Oversimplified Part 2. What did you think about this reaction? If you like this reaction, please make sure to subscribe to this channel. This is my backup channel. This is where I'm uploading like 3 videos a day, and also like my main channel just came out of a copyright strike, and you know, it's a painful, but you know, I'm uploading like 2 videos over there every day, so go check it out. The link will be in the description. If you like it, there's like entertaining, they're really entertaining videos, so you will thoroughly be entertained, so go check it out. And if you like it there, subscribe over there, okay? And if you like this reaction, subscribe over here, okay? Subscribe to both my channels, show me support, all right? Subscribe to both my channels, okay? And if you have any cool politics videos like this, amazing historical videos like this that you want me to react to, or any kind of video, music video, anything, any video that you love that you want me to react to, please type down in the comment section. I'll note it down and react to it. I'll even say your name, okay? So yeah, Hitler Oversimplified Part 2. My God, there's no, you know what, this is like the one thing, one animated video that you know, I'm so happy that I, you know, I'm so thoroughly, the video itself is so awesome, okay? It explains everything, really good narration, really careful narration of what Hitler did and everything. But I'm also like glad that there's no part 3, because my God, imagine if there's a part three, that that would just more terribleness, and it would be in real life. It would be so fucked up, okay? But yeah, Hitler Oversimplified Part 2. I'm going to watch other politics videos in this channel, Oversimplified. Go check out this channel. These people have like really good amount of subscribers, really good. Like one of the only few channels that has good amount of subscribers, 7.4 million subscribers. I want you to go subscribe to them. These people make really good content. And these videos have been made like so many years ago, 5 years ago, this thing with 26 million views, 2017. Really good, talented stuff. Awesome stuff. These people know their history, and I am like some South Indian guy, so I don't know anything. So watching these videos is a very big education for me. And also, like, a lot of people comment like big texts of information of what exactly happened and whatnot. You know, some of my viewers comment really big texts. I read them all, and I really understand them all, okay? So I really appreciate your comments. If you want to say something to me, please type down in the comment section. Please type down really big, explain to me, because I don't know much about, you know, the entire world. I'm just some Indian guy somewhere in the South India, okay? So it's crazy, okay? So please, you know, if you want to talk to me, please type down the comment section. I'll talk to you. Okay, and if you have any video suggestion that you want me to react to, please type down in the comment section. Okay, so yeah, please subscribe to both my channels, and I'll see you guys in the next oversimplified video, whatever that is. Okay, whatever it is, I'll see you guys in the next video. Okay, goodbye.